Hey everyone, it's Flakfire. Battlefield 2042 is a bit rough around the edges right now, but there are still a lot of cool details that show developers care about the game and put a lot of effort into their work. For this video, and to help keep up some positive energy, we're going to take a look at 10 of them. Before we get into that, special thank you to Keeps for sponsoring this video. No one wants to talk about it, but it's an unfortunate truth that 2 out of every 3 guys will experience some form of male pattern baldness by the age of 35. You want to address that early, and Keeps doesn't mess around. Meet with an actual doctor who reviews your information and sets up a plan. Get affordable FDA-approved generic medication shipped right to your door, and track progress with Keeps' online tracking tool. Keeps is trusted by hundreds of thousands of men and has more 5-star reviews than any of its competitors. So if you're ready to take action and prevent hair loss, go to keeps.com/flakfire or click the link in the description to receive 50% off your first order. That's keeps.com/flakfire. So let's talk about some details. For number one, Battlefield 2042 is basically a zoo. There are plenty of different kinds of animals out there on various maps. You can spot crabs on Valparaiso and Portal, and snakes among the dunes on Hourglass. However, what really steals the show for me are the penguins on Breakaway. These are modeled after emperor penguins, which are native to Antarctica, which is where this map is set. You can't shoot them in-game, no need to get upset, PETA, but the penguins will actually slide into the water when alarmed. You can see some in the distance as well. And fun fact for the day, a group of penguins is called a waddle. Next, let's talk about hovercrafts, you know, the unstoppable weapon of mass destruction in Battlefield 2042. I suspect their ability to scale skyscrapers might be patched out in the future, but for now, there are some cool details on the vehicle model. The most noticeable for me was that the skirt actually inflates or deflates depending on whether or not it's occupied. Developers could probably have gotten away without this detail, but it is a nice nod to how the machine works. For number three, let's take a close look at the Ranger. As man's best mechanical friend, this call-in is an armed robot dog. It's wonderfully detailed from its appearance to its mannerisms. You can see the visual sensor spinning to help it navigate the environment, and if you listen closely, you'll notice that Ranger actually talks. The robot barks and makes other vocalizations to alert you to enemies. Many players don't know that you can order Ranger to a particular spot, and you can even order it to self-destruct. It also deploys a parachute if it jumps from a significant height. For the next detail, listen closely. Did you hear it? You can actually hear the sound of the trigger resetting on the weapon once it's released. This happens with just about every weapon in Battlefield 2042, and there are a ton of other weapon details. I'll probably do a video just on these alone, but for example, I've noticed with the MP28 reload, the operator pulls the spare magazine from the foregrip on the first reload and then from the pouches on the rest. Trigger discipline, also huge in Battlefield 2042, you'll see the character shift their finger to a safe position when not handling the weapon for combat. Next, C5 in Battlefield 2042 is a blast. It sticks to almost everything. Cars, tanks, drones. I love the fact that I can use it with Sundance as a specialist. It essentially allows you to become a bomber for a fleeting moment, and that of course leads to some fun clips if you're lucky, but I want to talk about the detonator for the C5. Every time you punch the button, a little message pops up on the detonator screen. Most of them are witty, including ouch, even if it is technically misspelled. For number 6, let's check in with medical specialist Maria Falk. Falk has a syringe pistol in Battlefield 2042, which allows you to shoot teammates and heal them at range. This is a really useful feature in the game, especially since the syringes magnetize to nearby friendlies to make healing them easier. But, well, what about healing yourself? You might not have even known this is an option, and it turns out there are actually 2 different ways to do it. First, you can directly inject yourself using the pistol, and Falk will actually bleed the weapon's power first. The second is to shoot a dart into the ground, and if you walk over it, it will heal you. This is actually quicker than the self-heal animation, and it works on walls and other objects as well. You can also kill enemies if you hit them with syringe darts, though it takes quite a few to do it. At number 7, the RHIB in Battlefield Portal is extremely detailed. Resurrected from Battlefield 3, the RHIB's controls actually work. You'll notice that the throttle moves with your actions, but for me, my personal favorite touch is the functional compass. This actually syncs with the infantry compass, and that means you can use it to make callouts on maps. The RHIB has some other cool details, like the propeller actually spins. Next, there are interactive objects on maps. From small to large, there are quite a few of these, and they are more useful than you might think. You can close doors, raise ramps or bollards, or even reenact one of the Battlefield 2042 trailers by dropping the side of a ship on enemies, or friendly, so be careful with that. I actually found out that if you're close enough, there's a blast of air that actually pushes you backwards when that wall comes down. You should be able to activate most of these remotely with Nabenrau's hacking ability. For number 9, this one is a little bit of an Easter egg. I love the different advertisements on the maps in Battlefield 2042. They add to the environment and the world, and there are some really interesting ones like PSAs on what to do in a sandstorm, or there are some other ones that, for example, advertise energy drinks. My favorite, though, is probably the ad for the fake action blockbuster McArthur. You may not know this, but this is a deliberate nod to one of the game's producers, Ryan McArthur. It's not the first time that DICE have snuck in an Easter egg like this, and I would say it probably won't be the last. Lastly, at number 10, it's time to learn something new about Irish Grave's deployable cover. This gadget is great for stopping bullets, but it can actually stop even more, including elevators and zip lines. If an elevator door is open, you can deploy the cover in the doorway. This actually blocks the elevator doors from closing and thus prevents the elevator from operating. You'll notice the elevator keypad even mentions here if it's blocked. This is the perfect way to limit team access to rooftop objectives. You can also place the cover in the way of zip lines, and that causes problems for your foes. To sum it up, there are tons of other details in Battlefield 2042. I'll even toss out a bonus here. The tornado changes color based on what it's sucking up. For example, if it's over land, it's going to be brown. If it's over water, it's going to be white. If you've noticed any others on your own during your time in Battlefield 2042, please tell me down below in the comments. I'll be working on more similar videos to this one in the future, and once again, thanks to Keeps for sponsoring this video. If you enjoyed it, and do please try to enjoy it, I know Battlefield 2042 is in less than stellar shape right now, but dwelling on the negatives is only useful up to a point. So if you learned something new with this video, leave a like. If not, a dislike. Make sure to subscribe and tap the bell for the latest videos. If you want to say hi or hang out on Twitter, you can find all of the social media links down below in the video description. And as always, thanks for watching.